Yeah, so I'm going to talk about the novel method that we recently developed to treat multidrug resistant bacteria in water. Why it doesn't work? Okay, so the motivation is that recently the CNN News and the CDC News, I mean, as you know that we have Hurricane Irma last year, Hurricane Harvey in Texas, and the flood water, when people, you know, contact in the flood water, you know, there is a significant risk with the deadly bacteria. Mostly is a multidrug resistant bacteria present in water. So we are thinking about to develop a new method, alternative method to the conventional chlorine disinfection due to the you know, potential issue with the conventional in terms of the cost effectiveness and the longevity of the effectiveness. So the hypothesis is that what if we make it you know, nanomaterial that coated with biodegradable materials so that we can minimize the leaching issue of the nanomaterial in water. Second of all, you know, if with the coating biodegradable material onto the you know, certain types of especially metal oxide nanoparticle that have a high antibiotic bacteria resistant bacteria, so that we can have better control in terms of targeting the drug resistant bacteria. Now, another hypothesis would be, you know, reactive oxygen species generation. So because, so that with the release generation of reactive oxygen species, you know, the nanomaterials from the aerosol generation can treat it and target particular types of bacteria in water. So the goal is to develop an advanced new antimicrobial resistant bacteria, multi-drug resistant bacteria, especially to deal with difficult to treat contaminant of concern. So this is the you know, alginate encapsulated zinc oxide. It's new antimicrobial materials. The without the zinc oxide nanomaterial coated on the bead, nothing happened. So no removal in water. But when we coated the zinc oxide, which is one of the material that has a high antibacterial resistant bacteria can easily remove the you know, the bacteria present in water. So alginate encapsulated zinc oxide bead were successfully synthesized, and we saw that significant removal. Now people are confused with whether E. coli is a deadly bacteria, but there are many different types of bacteria present in water. So the E. coli that we used was DH5 alpha type, which is one of the you know, antibiotic resistant bacteria. And also Pseudomonas aeruginosa. This is the one of the multi-drug resistant bacteria. So we found out that very interesting, significant removal with only small amount of zinc oxide in encapsulated in the alginate bead. The alginate is an environmentally friendly biodegradable material. So in order to confirm the possible mechanism, so one of the hypotheses we came up is the release of reactive species. So what about if we minimize the aerosol generation? So we added the scavenger NAC. NAC is a scavenger of ROS. So adding the NAC, we found the significant inhibition of aerosol generation. So which confirm one of the primary mechanism responsible to treat the bacteria in water. So the future research direction is that we want to test it, how reusable it is, the bead, how reusable the bead are, and the further application you know, is to optimize it, the treatment parameter better. So we are currently working on the company, collaborating with the company Jacobs CH2M And this was supported by EPA, and my student working on this project. Thank you so much.